All right, so I chose this particular title because, well, in fact, they were pretty fancy. I think you saw from Scott's costume collection, there was something very performative about a lot of what they did. And so I think you can see it in the studio. I know many of you will have seen the studio space itself. This is the last of the studios they had over in the Bryce Avenue. It's their mother's former home that they gussied up to be their studio space. So this was the front room. Lots of period furniture, lots of antiquities, their examples of their art, and that sort of thing. But it was really once you got in the back of the house, the addition to the original building, that you truly saw a portion of their personality, their music room, the grand salon, two-story salon, and with the elaborate Baroque molding on the ceilings and these kinds of things. I mean, it was a fascinating space and a really good snapshot of the kind of individuals they were. The worlds they inhabited were fascinating. So let's quickly just take a look at the childhood, a few childhood images to get an idea of their family. So they're of a pair of four children. Peter was the eldest brother. Suzanne Gentling was their younger sister. And of course, they're in the back row there. A few examples of their early days at grade school. One of my favorite pictures here. These dangerous desperados, as you can see, in a standoff here. they clearly enjoyed, goofing off and loafing, as you saw from the film. High school, they're in the middle pictures. They were fraternal twins. Definitely, you can see the resemblance for sure. And really, then we take a look at them as people. So Scott and Stuart, although they were fraternal twins, they complemented each other, but were distinct individuals that overlapped in some aspects and were very different in many others. So Scott really was the reclusive, contemplative one of the pair. He's the one who quietly thought. But there was definitely an element of performance. I would say, if I were to hazard a word, he was a bit of a dandy. He liked, from the sheer quantity of these images from across his entire life, he loved to dress up and inhabit the historical past in an interesting way. Now he specifically said he didn't want to necessarily go back and live in that period, but he seemed to really enjoy inhabiting it through that tactile, firsthand, direct contact with the historical past through the artifact, the object. And in his case, it often includes costumes. And so this is from a whole series of photographs called The Rake's Progress, which refers back to Hogarth's Rake's Progress, which had some interesting parallels to Scott's biography. This one I love because here he is inhabiting the space of some of the big names of American art that precede him, Asher B. Durand and Rembrandt Peale. Peale has a self-portrait of him in a really, really similar costume. And Asher B. Durand, if you look at Kindred Spirits, is wearing this exact outfit as well. And so you can see him, again, referring back to the past, and making himself part of that that long continuum of artists and how they project their image. Nice example of the dandy here. The French Revolution was definitely an interest of theirs. Shows up in many of their compositions as well as the costumes. Of course, a direct reference to the Brady photographs. The home of a rebel sharpshooter. The Gettysburg. They visited the Gettysburg battlefield, and clearly Scott was entranced by the image and recreates it with himself as the subject. But you notice it's always him by himself. Stuart is the gregarious, expressive one. So they complement each other. Stuart is outgoing, he's talkative, but it expresses in a variety of ways. He'd be definitely very charming. So here he is, wowing Winona Judd, which is kind of fun. Hamming it up for the camera, clearly. But he cultivated patrons, people that were interested in his art. Here he is talking to the actor John Saxon during a visit here at Fort Worth. Takes him to the Kimball. They tour and talk about art and all these things. So he's really the one who serves as the front man for in many instances, although Scott could be charming at times as well if he wanted to be. Actively was in some ways the gatherer, the one who hunted the birds or acquired them, did a lot of the taxidermy of the specimens that would ultimately end up as subjects of their works. And so here you have Stuart and a friend out hunting. As I said, his gregariousness or his expressiveness took the form often of writing. There's so many magnificent examples of writing in the archive. So it's not just the Birds of Texas text that he wrote. There's all this text that goes along with their Aztec works, short stories, compositional pieces on a variety of subjects. Stuart learned, he knew Spanish. He also knew Nahuatl, so he could speak the Aztec tongue, and became an expert that he, in this particular instance, was lecturing in Mexico City on the Aztecs to a room full of experts. So although he didn't have a degree, he was an amateur. He was an amateur only in the sense of that Renaissance man, gentleman naturalist or a gentleman historian of the past. These guys really knew what they were doing as scholars and as artists. And they did, of course, share interests. I mean, although Scott is usually the one seen in the costume, Stuart had his fair share of turns in outfits, so he's wearing a costume along with Scott. Both artists of significant prowess. As you saw in the video, Stuart is self-expresses as someone who had a looser, gentler style. Scott was hyper hard edge, realist, although he clearly didn't like that term. Whereas Stuart, his brushstrokes are looser, more impressionistic. Because they worked interchangeably on works and sometimes don't acknowledge who did what, you have to do a little theorizing about which hand touched which piece of the art. But you can often wager things like the clouds, the skies, something that Stuart was unusually good at, that soft kind of fluffiness that you get in a lot of the Gentling skies. It's probably Stuart, whereas Scott was the one doing all the really carefully delineated clapboards on the houses and these kinds of things. So it's interesting to see how they intersected in their art work.